have a brief moment of invocation to be led by Kathleen Faith Jane Rodriarma of MRB. Faith, please.
May I request everybody to please rise? Let's bow our hands and place ourselves in the presence of God. Dear Lord, we stand before you in humble prayer before we start with this technology forum. May we ask for your blessing and divine providence that the activities set for this undertaking be successful and effective. We humbly ask you to shower our speakers today of your greatest inspiration so that they may share the most of their knowledge, heart, and soul to their respective topics. May we also retain the invaluable knowledge and learning experiences that we derive from this activity for actual application when we leave this venue. We pray that you bless each one of us, that may we fulfill our task responsibly, that the objectives we have set may all be achieved. Your generous blessing will mean the success of this activity. May we be living witnesses of your genuine love through the implementation of the knowledge acquired through this activity. Grant us your divine wisdom as we go about our daily tasks after this forum. We ask all this through your mighty name. Amen.
You may now be seated. We would like to thank each and every one of you for coming over to listen to our Techno Forum. And before we start, I would like first to at least acknowledge the universities or the groups that are here right now whom I have talked to a while ago. And I will not be able to mention your agency or your affiliation, just please let us know and acknowledge, okay? So first, we would like to thank those coming from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, including the whole of Saray team, Project Saray team. May we request you to please stand and let's give them a big hand. Okay, those are the project staff, personnel of the UPLB Saray project team. And also, I think we have some people from Department of Science and Technology, Region 12. Please stand. Thank you for coming. And then I think we also have people from Batangas State University, the students. Okay. Isang pulong sila. And we also have some people from the private sector, independent people from independent organizations. Can you please stand? So we have there one at the back and one in the group. And they're saying they're coming. And of course, we have the Picard group. We have Sarah, Faith, Dr. Batanon, and yours truly, Ophelia Domingo, and one at the back, Dori Armada. So, meron po ba kami, and also, before I forget, we have one from Camarines Norte State College. Okay. And meron po ba kami ng, hindi na-acknowledge, can you please help us know you? Sino po? Don't be shy. Yes? Yes? Okay, we have from UP, LB, Lead of Agricultural Biotechnology students. Please stand. Our former director of the Picard, Director Picard. And we have a new newcomer named Ma'am. May we know your affiliation? Because UPLB as well. Sorry, Ma'am. Okay? So thank you everyone for coming. So before we proceed to our techno forum, may we request our Director of the Agricultural Resources Management Research Division of PICARD to give us a brief welcome remarks. Dr. Juanito T. Batalon.
Thank you.
different agencies here. May we know the newcomers, where they came from, what school or agencies? Can you please stand and use the mic if you like? Lilis. What is Lilis? Sorry, po. Is it a school? Is it a school?
Yes.
University?
Yes.
Okay, so anyway, it's a school. Okay, thank you for coming. Thank you very much. Okay, so our speaker for today is a professor in agricultural engineering at the Institute of Agricultural Engineering, College of Engineering and Agroindustrial Technology. He is actually the project leader of Sarai Enhanced Agricultural Monitoring System that uses remote sensing and geographic information system technology for agricultural applications. He teaches courses on environmental control engineering, plant climate, farm structures, waste management, agricultural production and processing systems, computer-aided drafting and design, geographic information systems, and remote sensing. Masyadong techie, ano po? So, he has conducted research and extension works in the same fields. So, let us welcome our first speaker for today, Prof. Moises A. Dorado.
Good morning to all. So, hindi na yata umuulan, no? Sa labas. Kahapon, medyo and I think this is possibly indication of our ever-changing climate. So, what I will be presenting is actually a component of a bigger project which I will be also introducing you. Yung aming project is uses advanced technology, but I think the technology right now is not working. Antayin po natin about it. We have been doing this project for the past almost 3.5 years. Through the gracious funding of PICARD, the OST. We have been recently granted an extension for another 3 years so that we can work more in terms of improving, refining whatever we have started during those 3 years. Proceeded with my lecture. Maybe we can just wait for you.
Sorry for that, pero kanina ready na yung presentation biglang online. So we do not own this venue and it's the World Trade Center who will be fixing this. But I think Prof. Duboy, kuka muna para hindi ka while waiting from the person from the World Trade Center building to fix our audiovisuals here, this is impromptu. May I request Prof. Vicky Espaldon, sorry ma'am ha, bigla ko kayong tinawag, to give us a very brief background about Project Sarai while they are fixing. I will be giving that. Just a very brief background, just to buy time while we are waiting. Actually, probably Victoria Espaldon is the program leader. Overall,
Ang project sa NAI ay hindi lamang UPLP. Ito ay kasama yung ating iba pang mga state universities and colleges. We have 11 partners, SUCs from Isabela State, U, from Luzon to Mindanao. For Luzon, we have Isabela State University. Meron tayong MMSU, Mariano Marcos State University, CLSU, Central Luzon State University, tapos meron tayong Mindoro State Agricultural College, sa Bicol, Bicol University, sa Visayas, sa Palawan meron tayong WPU, Western Philippine University, sa Visayas meron tayong Cebu Technical University at sa Cagubsu, Western Visayas State U. Sa Mindanao, meron tayong USTP, University of Science and Technology, CMU, Central Mindanao University, USM, University of Southern Mindanao, and other partners. Sa government agencies naman, meron tayong partner sa BSWM. Ang sino may alam ng ibig sabihin ng BSWM? Bureau of Soils and Water Management. Ay, yung PAGASA. Pinakamahaba yan. So, kasama din natin ang PAGASA. Kasama natin ang Philippine Coconut Authority. Kasama natin ang Sugar Regulatory Agency, SRA, at kasama natin ang, isa pa, PCIC, Philippine Crop Insurance Company. And why? Because one of the major climate adaptation for agriculture we're looking at is really the risk transfer mechanism. Ang ibig sabihin nun, itatransfer natin yung climate risk sa insurance agency. So, ito ay in line with the overall plan for climate resilient agriculture. Na okay na ba? Di ba? Mahaba pa ako. Kaya ko ito maghapon. Sayang na lang pagiging kong profesor. Anyway, so that's only introducing the major stakeholders. Of course, meron tayong mga, ating major, kasama natin ang UP Diliman. Kasi ang UP Diliman, meron naman silang drought crop forecasting for agriculture. Sa ano naman ito, sa rice and corn. Ang coverage ng ating saray, initially, sabi ni Prof. Dorado kanina, ay ito ay phase 2. Sa phase 1, meron tayong 6 na crops na covered lang natin. Yung coconut and banana, coffee and cacao, tsaka rice and corn. Ngayon, dinagdagan natin ng sugarcane, soybean, tsaka tomato. So, may 9 na tayo na crops. And we hope to cover all other crops using the same protocol. Ang ginagawa nila, maraming component ang saray, hindi lamang yung ipipresent dito, dalawa lang po yun. Ang part of major component din ng saray is to put together all data in one portal, which will be available to the public. Ito po yung saray portal, www.saray.ph. Kung may ano, lahat ng mga information na meron ang saray nandun, tsaka yung mga outputs. Okay na tayo? May tanong ba kayo? Pwede na po tayo mag-start. Okay, thank you very much.
Maraming salamat po, Dr. Carbon, for that very urgent SOS move from you talagang maasahan ka mo. So, let's go back to Prof. Moises Dorado for his presentation.
Salamat, Ma'am. Vicky. Alam niyo po sa Project Sarai, we are a group of multidisciplinary team. And teamwork. Kita niyo naman ang sumalo sa akin yung aming pinaka-head. Ganun po kami. And in fact, during the 3.5 years na ginagawa namin yung project, madaming mga schools, other institutions na gusto, pag narinig nila, gusto sumama, and we have been accommodating them. Bukas tayo for the benefit of agriculture and our poor farmers. Now, let me start my talk before it bugs down again. Okay? Let me start with a very simple graph. This very simple graph, I'll show you later, was able to save or was instrumental in saving a big nation, yung Russia. I don't know if you have heard in 2010, merong headline ang National Geographic. Ang headline nila, Russia is burning, Moscow is choking. Bakit? Russia during that time was being hit by heat wave. So they were experiencing heat wave. Okay? So yung threat ng heat wave na experience dun sa urban area, sa ano nga? Sa Moscow during that time, I'm seeing may naka-mask din sila, no? During that time talaga. And then, ang isang product ng malaki ng Russia is yung wheat. And they are a major exporter. During that time, Russia needs to decide whether to go on exporting their wheat or hold it for their own consumption. So the big question to be answered is, if they are, during that time in May of 2010, nandito sila, no? They are here, they are at this condition. By the way, this cloud of data, puro data yan, puro points yan, more than 4,000 points, forming a cloud, almost a cloud, that represent the combination of rainfall and temperature. During the time that they were experiencing the heat wave, they are only at this point. Now, they need to have an information on how to decide whether to go on exporting, if the condition would be better, or hold it if the condition will be worse, magpe-persist sa heat wave. So, anong ginamit nila? Ginamit nila this simple graph. And they forecasted, pinredict, ano? So, gumamit sila ng nitong system na to, and they were able to predict that by June, it will become worse. Worse, why? Because the temperature will increase and then the rainfall will further decrease. So, lalong-lalo na sa agriculture. If you have high temperature and low rainfall, drought ang kasunod. Okay? They predicted also from May to June, then to July, hindi pa rin gaganda. Ibig sabihin, itong conditions na to are well beyond what is normally experienced. Dito sa gitna nitong cloud na to, yun yung on the average. So they were able to decide that no, we will not be exporting. We will rather save what we have right now for domestic consumption. And they were right. Okay? The production fell to 70 to 75 from as high as 97 in 2009. So this simple tool, this simple graph of a cloud of data of rainfall and temperature was instrumental in saving Russia in terms of possible shortage of wheat. Now why did I present this? This essentially inspired us, our group, dun sa Sarai. Our curiosity was aroused. Can we have the same tool for our Philippine agriculture? Wouldn't it be nice if we can also have a prediction of, let's say, the severity of drought of El Nino. We have been experiencing El Nino. Can we have a forecast for that? Can we have the same simple tool to guide us? The typhoon that we are experiencing, the heavy rains, can we have the same tool for us? So yun yung nag-inspire sa amin. Testingin natin. Testing, ano? Okay? So, what we did, sorry again. So what we did was to test it in our situation. The severest El Nino that we have experienced in the Philippines was during this 1997-98, okay? So ito yung El Nino. And this is the same cloud of data that you have seen dun sa Russia. We use our own data to check, to try. Could we have projected, could we have forecasted the severity of El Nino that will be experienced during that 1998? And we were able to show that. This one, this is already hindcast. Ang tawag kasi doon sa forecast, yung hindi pa nangyayari. But ito nangyayari na. But what we did was to make use of the historical record before 1998. And then, this is the forecast. So medyo lalo kami na-excite. Mukhang kaya natin, no? Mukhang kaya natin. Okay, so pumapalili yung ating technology, ma'am. Pasensya na. Okay. This is also the same graph. Medyo mas maganda na ng kaunti ang presentation. But you can look on the right side. The same type of graph. But this time, okay, may kwento ito, no? During our yung conduct of Saray, we have been doing trainings. Nationwide po ito, nationwide. And it was in one of our trainings sa North Cotabato, doon po sa Kabakan, sa USM. During that time, we were there, it was supposed to be yung fruit festival. And according to them, during fruit festival, doon sa Kidapawan, nakaparada, no? Yung mga fruits nila. Beti ba yun? Madami. But during our time, wala. It was the first time, really, in so many years that they have experienced this. Okay? So sabi namin, tingnan nga natin, let's try to use our system. Kung kaya niya, kung ginamit natin ito, na foresee kaya niya on what could have happened. Okay? This is a 6 months forecast or hindcast. Ginamit namin, no? Anong nakita namin? Yung nandung mga red, those are extreme values. Extreme na, hindi katulad kanina, no? Doon sa unang dalawang graph. Ito extreme na, mataas ang rainfall, mataas ang temperature. So why did it have an impact na walang fruits? Okay? The reason for which, based on interaction with other experts, yung mataas na rainfall at saka mataas na temperature, this has, okay, affected the growth ng iyong mga plants. Instead of, okay, having your fruits sa napunta, dun sa vegetation. And ito yun, no? This is the 6 months before that fruit festival. If we could have used this one, no? Kasi nag-uumpisa pa lang eh. Nag-uumpisa pa lang kami noon. But now we are ready. Okay? But during that time, okay, nagamit namin, nangyari na. But this time, yun, gagamitin namin. A very simple tool, okay, that aroused our curiosity, no? Looking at the Russian experience and doing it for the Philippines. We can do it. Okay? So, dito na, no? Naggawa na, buo na yung kinatawag natin na SEALS. The Saharan Hats Agricultural Monitoring System. And this is part of a bigger program. Ang ibig sabihin po ng Saraya, yun, nandun. Smarter approaches to reinvigorate agriculture as an industry in the Philippines. This is funded by Picard. Thank you sa funding ng Picard and DOST. Pero kung isipin nyo, bakit DOST and Picard yung magpa-fund dun sa agriculture? Because we want to really make use of whatever technology we have, lalo-lalo na dun sa ating poor farmers. We should realize that our farmers, especially our poor farmers, are at the forefront of our fight against climate change. Diba? Sila yung most vulnerable to climate change. And therefore, if this is the case, we need to really pour our resources into using these technologies for them. And yun yung aming dream, no? Dream ng Saray, dream ng museums. And let me walk you through that dream. Okay? Ito si farmer. Okay? What we want to do, is to guide the farmer and his carabao with the advanced technologies that we have. And ang nakita namin dito will be yung satellite. No? Satellite remote sensing. Okay? Pero sabi nga namin, no? Sabi nga namin, yung carabao mas reliable pa rin for the farmer. Bakit? Kasi yung satellite naman, hindi naman magamit immediately ni farmer. So our aim is to be able to bring this technology so that it can be used really by the farmer. Para hindi lang kami researchers or even you ang makakagamit nito. The first three graphs that I have presented earlier, meron siyang kailangan, no? Katulad ng isang engine. Yung engine hindi tatakbo pagka walang fuel. So what would fuel really? Yung pinakita ko kaninang simple graph, what would fuel it is yung data. No? Kung wala yung data, kung tatatlong points yun, hindi rin siya magagamit na ayos. So we tried to look at the stars. Diba usually, nung una-una, titingala para malaman saan kami kukuha ng data. Diba? And so we literally looked at the stars and found among the stars itong mga satellites na ito. And meron dyan, no? Yung Diwata 1 and 2 na. Dalawa na yun. I don't know if you're aware, meron na. Meron na ang Pilipinas. Na only micro pala. Yung maliit yung inalagay dito. Micro pala. Still, it is a leap forward, no? Na magamit natin. Okay? So, ito ang paggagalingan natin ng information. So, yung question kanina, where will the data come from? Especially, lalo na sa malalayong lugar. Maybe you're aware, wala namang measurement to, even ang rainfall. temperature. Lalo-lalo na, pinag-uusapan natin, mahabang duration. Or so many number of years of record. Saan yung gagaling? They will come from this advanced technology. And so we can really call it as a smart approach this time for our agriculture.
Quantified
quantified information like the spectral signature. Kung tayo may signature natin and nakikilala ah, signature ito ni Juan, signature ito ni Juana. The same is true with our crops. Your satellites capture this kind of information and translate them into this example. This is what you call as a spectral signature. A certain crop will have its own spectral signature, so that once you obtain those spectral signature from the satellite, you can say this is rice and this is corn. And Dr. Espaldon mentioned earlier yung aming initial na saray, phase 1, it involved 6 crops. Let me mention them again. Rice, corn, then we have coconut, coffee, cacao, and banana. And we have already a library of the signatures of these different crops. And we are very willing to share the information that we have already with us. No? Of course, through the through Picard. No? So, kailangan may permission from Picard. But, yeah, we are open. So, kumbaga, meron na tayo. And what is the use of knowing? Diba? Okay. You see from the spectral signature, this is rice, and then this is corn. But if you do not use it further, then it will not amount much. Okay? So, ito nga yung ating spectral signature. And in this example, this is the spectral signature of a rice. From this spectral signature, you can actually look at the health of the crop. You can say right now that in Isabela, if I have the data, I can say it is not performing well. Or the crop, standing crop is just okay. I can also say from this spectral signature that there is planted, that the area is planted, okay, because of this spectral signature. And so the monitoring aspect of SIMS is really needed for us to be able to guide yung ating farmers. Okay? We need to guide them, lalong-lalo na yung tinatawag natin na near real time. Hindi na yung after pang makapag-harvest, sasabihin natin kay farmer, ah, the reason why you have low yield is because of this. No, we don't want to arrive at that point. What we want is that, okay, you have a planted rice, this is the stage, and this is the kanyang health. Okay, it is doing well, or you need to apply some more fertilizers, some more water. So, hindi lang makita, no, malaman kung anong crop, but the ability to monitor the crop health. We can do that. And like this one, no, this is an enlarged image. Dito, kita natin yung green ones, this is a corn area. Yung green ones represent the healthy ones. And then, yung iba, yung brown na brown, the harvest na. Yung iba naman, okay, medyo hindi maganda yung health. So, we can use those data from remote sensing. Again, those data are free. The tools to process them are also free. And in fact, when we conduct trainings dun sa iba't ibang lugar, we always leave them with the tools because they are free. We show them where to get those free information. So right after the training, they can do their own processing and monitoring. But we don't leave them. No? Definitely, we don't leave them na, okay, tapos na. Because of the advent of the internet, no? Hindi lang sa Facebook dapat tayo magaling. No? Pati dun sa paggamit ng technology. Okay. Another important application is being able to look at or to monitor and assess the damage of yung flooding. Lalo-lalo na ito, parating na ngayon. Kita natin talaga yung area. Okay? It is very important, lalo-lalo na for monitoring purposes and planning purposes of the Department of Agriculture. Makita mo, saan ka talaga bumaha? Kasi we should not stop at knowing bumaha sa barangay na gano'n. Pero hindi naman yung buong barangay, right? So, saan talaga doon? Tinamaan ba talaga yung crop areas? So, because of satellite remote sensing, and because of the processing that we can use, we have the data. We have the sufficient data to do this. Okay? Ito, mamaya ipipresent ng isa namin kasama, si Doc Melvin, yung sa, ano rin, sa pest, no? Pest and diseases, pwede natin ma-monitor. Okay? Malaman natin, aling mga areas talaga yung severe infestation and so on. Because remember, the satellite can see, you know, yung a large area all at once. Yun ang kagandahan niya. Diba? So, kita niya agad. Hindi lang makikita isang farm. But it can really look at, okay, the whole country in several hours or even in one shot. Yung iba, so, kanina binabanggit ko yung ating rainfall and temperature. This is an example of the data that we can have. That is monthly rainfall and then temperature. You can access actually more than 30 years of record of rainfall and temperature which you can use, which we have been using. This example na graph kanina. So, question is, how can we give this information to the farmers? Isa yun yung sabi natin kanina. Hindi pa rin siya papakinabangan ng farmer. Si Carabao pa rin ang preferred niya kung hindi natin ito madadala. We cannot transform this information into an information that can be useful. It can be understood by the farmers. So, yun ang ginagawa namin. Saray. Meron kami na iba't ibang methods on how to transfer this information. So, to transfer through text, so radio, and so on. So, hindi ko na mapakita on how we do that. But that is the objective. So, that is objective. Kasi kung sabihin mo, okay, alam niyo yan. Alam niyo mag-process. Pero, paano si farmer? So, we can text the farmer, okay, in the next three days, ganito yung magiging ulan. So, kung ganito yung ulan, you can apply this mulch fertilizer. Okay? O kaya, in 6 months, ganito yung magiging ulan for the first month, second, and so on. So, you can decide, do I proceed to plant? Do I select a new crop to plant? It will be more sturdy against drought. So, this ability to be able to provide farmers this kind of information near real time or even ahead of time. Okay? Yun ang gusto natin mangyari. Lalo-lalo na if we talk about climate change. We need to prepare. How do we prepare? It is not complete to know that temperature will rise, rainfall will be stronger. But we need to know how much, how many degrees, right? So, yung rainfall mo, how many millimeters or volume of rainfall do you expect? I was mentioning earlier na yung kinakapture na information is not only yung mawabuk, the whole of province, but it can go down to this level. Look at this. This is, okay? The province of Isabela. And from here, makikita natin yung dot na yun, yung maliit na yun sa gitna. This is this information. And we can provide, yung SIMS can provide what we call a site specific down to this level of farm. This is an 8-hectare corn production area, so may iba malalaki pang plantation within that 8-hectare. Because of the data we are able to collect, to process, analyze, and interpret, we can provide this kind of advisories. Masasabi natin, yung sa inyo pong farm, ganito yung posibleng magagawa. So what we have done in the past 3.5 years was, we have been conducting, okay? We have been training people from different sectors. Nabanggit na ni Doc Vicky kanina, no? We have been working with SUCs, state universities and colleges. Meron din yung iba't ibang agencies, particularly sa DOST as well as DA, Department of Agriculture. Even down to the municipal level. Okay? Ang hindi pa namin nagawa talaga will be a more intensive interaction with the farmer. We have more interaction with the agricultural technicians. So this is a phase two. This is what we'll be doing. We'll try to remodel SIMS. And we are calling it right now yung community level SIMS. And this community level SIMS, the idea is for us to get information from the community. Ano ba talaga yung kailangan para ma-incorporate siya dun sa system? Because right now, in our assessment, ito yung posibleng kailangan ni farmer, but in their assessment, ito yung kailangan. Okay? Ito yung form of data, information that they need, baka hindi yun yung form of information that we now have. So, we will try to harmonize this together with the farming communities. So we will call this the CLCs. And hopefully, next year, if we meet again in such a forum, we'll be presenting the community level CLC. So sabi ko nga po, nakipag-interact na kami sa mga farmers in the different communities. Ito yung aming iba't ibang mga members. Okay. So, again, SARAI, Enhanced Agricultural Monitoring System, this is SIMS. To tell you the truth, so magko-confess na ako, to tell you the truth, if you look at it, we have not developed any new technology. Remote sensing is already there, right? Neither have we developed a new tool in GIS, and some of the other tools, mathematical tools, are also there. What we believe in our heart is that we have developed a new hope for our Filipino farmers. A new hope. Why? Because DOST and Picard is pouring right now a lot of resources so that whatever science and technology can offer to the farmer can give him hope, especially in battling climate change. So, yun po yung gusto namin, sa tingin namin, no? In our heart, yung hope ang aming nag-create. So that in the end, ito pong bilao, no? In Tagalog, or bilao ang tawag natin. In the end, okay, we can give the farmer a bountiful harvest, providing the best that science and technology can provide. Down to the small poor farmers. Thank you.
time, we would like to entertain a few questions. It's open forum time. Do you have anything to clarify? Just please raise your right hand, and when you do so, please, there's a mic there. Please tell your name and the agency affiliation, or no, if no agency, just say private. Because we are recording this open forum.
My name is Diana from Metro Alpha Association. My question, sir, okay na po na start ng ating pag-aaral ng project sa ako? Ilan naka-ilang years na po tayo?
3.5 years. 3.5 years na po.
So wala pa sa mga talaga, kumbaga actual na mga farmers na nakaka-experience pa actual na
kaupondi po ko. Mas intensive po namin na this is in particular yung SIMS po. So yung sa SIMS po, hanggang ang aming intensive interaction is with the agricultural technicians. But we have been also having some dialogue with farmers, pero hindi pa po ganun ka, sabihin natin, extensive yung kanilang adoption.
Sir, kung sakali po ito ay magiging mga po, no? Tumago eh. Paano gagawin to lahat? Meron ba itong monitoring terms, no, to access? For example, if I am a private individual, I have 5 hectares, and I would like the technology, I'm here in Metro Manila, no, and my farm is in Davao. Okay? So, I would like to just go through yung ano, aking computer, at nakikita ko na yung farm ko. We have to go through you, we can go directly, in what way?
Okay. Ma'am, right now, meron po isang component yung Project Sarai. And this is yung ating knowledge portal. Ito po yung sa, through internet, you can access the website. And we have, dun po yung mga process information. Information that easily users, even down to the farmers level, can understand. So in the case that you're mentioning, ma'am, those information will be available. What will have some restrictions probably will be yung raw data. But in terms of yung mga process information, which one on our side we believe will be important for the users, for the down to the farmers, and other one, the one I've mentioned earlier, yung community level, na talagang papasok po dito yung gustong information na kakailanganin. That will become available for access.
Please stand and please
talk over that microphone.
Saray, yun ang sa Google Monitoring System.
Saray, come over here, sir, and get your free 100 peso worth of prepaid card. Congratulations. Hey, gusto niyo pa?
Yes.
Oh, gusto pa ng prepaid card. The next question is, ay, ito, madali lang po. What weather variables were used in the Russian experience? Andali. Oh, yes, naku, ang galing naman ito. Yes, ma'am. Please stand up and go to that microphone so you can be heard.
Rainfall and temperature.
Rainfall and temperature, very good. Congratulations, Miss Christelle from UPLB League of okay, we have one last question. Bob, pwedeng tatlo ang answers. So, pwedeng bawat isang may isang answer. Okay. Ito na yung, pinaka-importante. Saan ba ginagamit ang SIMS? Name a possible application for SIMS. So, Prof. Dorado mentioned at least five possible application for SIMS. So, nakita niyo yung mga maps, nakita niyo yung mga information from satellite, and all, where do we, what is the application of that SIMS? Where do we apply that? Anybody? Ah, mga 200 si sir, pero mamaya na kayo sir, baka naman meron, bigyan natin ng pagkakataon yung iba. Yes, sir. Please stand and tell your name. At least one.
I'm Jason Terensama from UPLB.
Okay.
The product could be used for image analysis, for identification of crops.
For crop identification, very good. Here goes 100% of our mobile prepaid card. Congratulations. So, we still have four applications ng SIMS. Yes? Please stand. Please.
Sorry. I'm Yan from UP League of Agricultural Water Technologies. UPN. One application of which is that it is able to identify the healthy crops in a particular area.
Identify healthy crops in a particular area. Okay, now, thank you, Prof. Last one. Ano pa yung possible application ng SIMS? Tapos, sagutin ko natin si Director Ina. Agriculture and Food Science, UPLB, University of the Philippines. the head of the NCPC Plant Biosecurity Division. His field of expertise is research and extension in plant disease, plant pest and disease forecasting, monitoring, and simulation. And as a study leader of the crop protection component of Sarai Phase 1 project, he spearheaded the development of advisories and simulation models of major pests and diseases of rice, corn, coconut, coffee, cacao, and banana. The Smarter Pest Identification Technology, or SPIDTECH, is also one of the main offshoots of the project as a collaborative effort of the Sarai team. He is also the current project leader of Insect Pest and Disease Advisory System under the Sarai Phase 2 project funded by DOSP Qatar. So ladies and gentlemen, let's all welcome our second speaker, Mr. Melvin D. Aguenda.
Android application, cellphone based. Android, hindi pa sa Apple. ibang anong extras. So dalawang main features niya, meron siyang Pest and Disease Library. Sabihin ng Pest and Disease Library, andun yung picture, andun yung mga ibang info, at yung mahalagang management, yung mahalagang problema, paano mo siya i-control, o paano mo siya susupin. And then, another main feature yung Pest and Disease Identification, kasi yung sisend ka lang picture, i-identify niya. Ngayon, kasi ang focus namin ay major pest lang. So kung hindi kaya ng computer, parang meron paraan na isi-send dyan sa mga expert tao na. Mga tao na yung mag-identify. So sa library yun, a knowledge portal of common pest and disease associated with rice, corn, banana, coconut, coffee, and cacao. So ito muna ang aming pinocus kasi talagang napakarami namang pest eh. Napakarami namang crops, lalo na lumbawa yung vegetables, sa dami ng vegetables, sa dami ng pest para hindi manageable. So, dito muna sa anim na crops ang aming nag-develop. Next. Ito ang pinoprovide niya, may images, may Filipino name o common name, meron din scientific name, merong identification signs at management practice. So ngayon, ano pa lang, papunti pa lang tayo niya. Kasi mag-version lang pa lang siya. Merong 62 pests and 36 diseases for rice, corn, banana, coffee, cacao, and coconut. So ganito ang parang halimbawa ng SPEDTECH library. Ayan, kunyari, sa disease, kunyari, ito. Corn grass, sheep light, corn, and then isa corn, dapat rice wash. And then, mga peste naman, mga semi-looper, corn borer, etc. Next. Ayan, parang kanina, mas enhanced. Meron siyang pagkakunan na ngayon. Parang ginagawa niya. Meron niya ang ganito yung slides kayo. Yan ang ID niya, pwede magawa sa tatlong paraan, three ways. So una, pwede ka mag-send ng picture, ika-capture ng phone camera. So kailangan yung phone mo, I mean, yung camera. Kaya yung pang-text lang, and then, kung meron ka ng picture dun sa camera mo, sa library niya, sa image, sa picture library niya, pwede mo rin isend. O kaya, pwede rin siya magtanong sa'yo kung hindi ka sigurado, halimbawa, yan. Pwede kang magbigay ng crop, anong saan crop siya problema. O kaya, pwede mo siyang describe. Next. So ang image processing ay yung ano, halimbawa, analysis and manipulation of the digitized image. At yung machine learning naman, yun, ginagamitan ng AI o artificial intelligence that provides the system the ability to automatically learn and improve on experience. So ibig sabihin na parang tao na siya, natututo siya, parang siya'y tinuturuan mo ng tinuturuan, natututo siya. So, bali ang nangyari dito sa SPEEDTECH, parang dinevelop siya ng computer science group ng Saray. And then, kami yung nag-train. Kasi kami sa crop protection, kami talaga yung gagamit. Kumbaga sila yung nag-create ng dog. Kami naman yung nag-train ng dog. Kaya, ang mahabang trabaho dito yung sa amin yung training kasi habang tumatagal, dapat mas marami na siyang nagagawa kung marami na silang pag-alip na identify. Kasi parang ma-identify niyo, kunyari, isang pest, kailangan makakita siya o lalagyan mo siya ng halos 100 meters, no? Or less, para matulog siya. Ngayon, ang sistema namin kasi cellphone-based, dapat mas responsible, kaya niyang ma-identify yung galing sa cellphone lang. Kaya wala naman tayo limit kung ilang megapixels ang ano, di ba? Medyo maganda yung image, sharp image. So, ganito ang parang resulta niya. Kaya sa future plans namin, nagdagdagan na ng tatlo pang crops dito sa phase 2 ng saray. Sugarcane, soybean, and tomato. And then, i-improve pa namin yung speed and accuracy kasi ang accuracy ay ano pa ganun na hindi pa namin nangyayon ito mga siguro 80%. 90% yun ang target namin. Kaya yun, as time goes on, lalagyan pa namin na lalagyan siya ng mga pictures o i-improve pa namin yung apps. Then yun ang validation, mga test. Ngayon, kung gusto nyo access to, available na naman siya sa ano. Yung parang version 1 lang namin, kaya ibig sabihin, hindi pa siya ganun kagaling. Pwede na siya ma-access sa Google Play Store at gamit yung Android phone. I-search nyo lang yung SpeedTech at yung mag-install na siya. Parang may ano, parang demo na susunod na kung paano siya gamitin. Pero marami nang sumubok ito, pero I don't encourage you na gawin yun. Ang peste lang talaga ito. Ayan, yung makikita nyo, pagka-download nyo siya, ayan, power start. Ayan, ayan, image na kunyari yan, na-download ko yan. Mamimili ka. And then yun, i-click mo yung identify. Ibigyan mo ito. Ibigay na sa'yo yung nasa library na at ibang info. Ang pinakamahalaga naman yung management practices yung parang description. Yun ang insect pest example. Ngayon naman parang disease naman kunyari sa corn. Yan, bibigyan pa rin niya ng corn rust. And then, yung mga ibang information na nasa library. So, ito yung nasa library niya ngayon, yung mga diseases, mga corn pests. Sample lang ng mga nasa library ng tayo na. Sana kami actual demo kaya lang hindi kami nakadala ng sample. Okay, I think yun na lang.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Melvin Ebenga, for that very interesting presentation.
So, mga estudyante, nakita nyo ha, hindi pang ang cellphone is hindi lang pang Facebook, pang Instagram, o pang Twitter. Ang cellphone ay magagamit din natin lang na if your parents are farmers or if you have relatives na merong farm area na may problema sila sa pests and diseases. With this application, malalaman nyo kung anong pest yun, anong characteristics niya, at paano siya ititreat, paano siya makokontrol. Kasi meron din siyang management practices na niligay sa kanyang app. Diba? Ang galing? Okay. Any? Asan ang ating taga-WTC? This time, we are going, let's proceed to the open forum. Meron po bang mga katanungan? So, yes, ma'am. Ito po ang mic. Pwede kahit hindi na ikabets. Ang ating news ay mag-iikot na lang. Si Tay.
Sir, thank you po sa information po. Ang tanong ko po ay ang ating Department of Agriculture po ba ay equipped na po ba sa kanitong technology? Kasi sila ay all over the Philippines ang kanilang technician. So, siyempre, mas malapit sa mga farmers. Equipped na ba sila sa ating technology po?
Actually, marami naman silang sistema para sabihin ko na po yung mga aming pagdito. Pero yung parang sistema namin, yung mga aming pagdito. Kung dumarating yung siguro, mapahala ko sa ito. Pero so far, alam ko, field rights, meron din sila para mga test. Kaya hindi ko makapunin na lang siguro.
Pero kumbaga, ang hiwalay sa inyo, ano, sa inyong opisina, or are you affiliated, no? Do you work together, collaborate?
We work together naman. Yun lang, dito sa project na kapanin ng USP. Pero ang talagang client din namin na magagamit. Hindi talagang magagamit ng projects kung dapat magamit din sa kanila. Kaya kung baga, sisend namin sila as much as possible to train namin yung municipal agriculturist ng bawat
I think meron pong sasabihin si Prof. Ay, Dr. Espaldon. Sir, can you please occupy the center stage?
For the information of everyone, we're actually negotiating and talking with the Department of Agriculture. With respect to SpeedTech, ang sarap po kasi covers 9 crops na. Yung ginagawa ngayon ng field rice, we have a similar project for this, pero we are focused on the rice and corn. I think ganun din yun sa SIMS, yung monitoring. Right now, they have also similar, but they are focused on rice. So we have other commercial crops na of interest to Sarai. Negotiations is ongoing with Field Rice and Department of Agriculture. Ini-meet nga namin sila para may several meetings na kami. And open naman sila doon sa discussion. Kasi alam naman nila na limited yung current na technological development, yung development for techniques for different crops. Kaya may collaborations na mangyayari, particularly doon sa downloading, yung deployment ng system. We're looking towards a closer collaboration with DA in terms of deployment. Pero gusto rin namin ipasok sa DA yung paradigm shift ng extension, whereby yung ating mga SUCs, the science community, will be integral part of the extension agency of the Department of Agriculture. So yun yung mga current discussions natin na palagay ko naman ay pare-pareho yung mukhang maganda naman
kasi talagang kailangan mong naka-wifi ka eh para ma-connect ka. Ngayon kung pwede talagang i-download siya ng
data
para wala ng wifi.
No, I mean, sir, sa farms po yun, I mean, sa signal, in terms po na sa signal, I mean, hindi po alam yung malakas yung signal sa farms. So, would it be a problem po for using the applications para sa farms? Kasi, I mean, this app is for the farms.
Kumbaga, ang didevelop pa nga namin yung offline mode. Kumbaga, magawa namin yung nakikip na kailangan ng signal. Ayun, yung nakikagawa namin.
Thank you, sir.
Po, meron pa kong tanong? Yes, sir.
This is a relation to the question a while ago. I know that this is a silly question, but I'm just curious if you have looked into the cost effectiveness of the technology. Because as what has been raised a while ago, we know that most of our farmers are living remotely. In other words, there's no access to internet, there's no access to globe or smart signal. So my question is, Would it be cost effective if you just provide a brochure containing all the best to the farmers instead of coming up with this kind of technology?
Well, siguro, kaya lang, dynamic na lang kasi ang best problem natin. Mas madali ka magdagdag ang info pag nasa internet ka. Kung baka, ang habo lang naman natin dito ay yung fast sa. Pero, siyempre, mas mura talaga yung issue. Kaya lang, ano naman doon, kumaga, medyo mababay yung dissemination. Ang reach mo, kumaga, dapat mas mataas sa sa internet. And then, napakabilis ng development ng Wi-Fi, no? Kung para may plan, para may beer na kanitaasan ng ating internet speed. No? Kaya sa tingin ko, futuristic-wise, medyo may nabayo dito. Maganda ang resulta.
I think meron din po
yan
ang nasagot si picture, lalo yung mga nasa agriculture
natural na fields, ano po, mag-picture tayo ng mga vessel diseases and submit it. Kahit hindi ninyo siya kilala, kasi yung mga experts natin, like sila, Rockland, will help us identify them. And by sending photos, na-enrich natin yung database ng SPTEC. It becomes smarter. Para tayo din, the more we read, the more we learn. So, ganun din si SPTEC. So, help us in building up the
ang ganda ko lang, no? We are really encouraging you farmers or even the technicians to get yung picture dun sa field. Kasi ang isang dream ng saray, which we are incorporating dun sa, already incorporating dun sa Facebook, yung nabanggit yung mga crowdsourcing. Kasi pag nakuha namin, na ipadala sa amin, na dito sa site na to, in terms of the latitude, longitude, kasi pag kuha mo ng picture, may latitude, longitude yun. Mapa-plot yun. Mapa-plot. Pag nakita namin, uy, mukhang madami dito reported na pest. So, pag nakita namin yun, masuk sa system, we can be proactive. Makita namin, uy, posible na ito'y kumalat. Because of our model, kakalat yan. So, hindi lang for the purpose na ma-identify the farmer, ay, meron ng pest. No, but it is more in terms of really preventing the spread. Kaya sana, yun nga, sabi ni Ma'am, mag-contribute, yun yung ipapalaganap namin, encourage namin yung mga farmers because this will really help. Diba? Kasi pag masyadong madami na, tapos identify mo sa kakalamagan, mahirap.
Yun din minomodernize na natin, makikita ninyo yung pag-exhibit, di ba? Minomodernize ng ang agriculture. Ito naman, minomodernize din. Paano natin may empower ng ating mga farmers? But take note, not all the technologies and systems being create or develop nitong program nito or project nito ay hindi lang dapat itutok sa farmer. Kasi may mga conduit yan ng mga technologies eh. May certain level ng knowledge and resources ng farmer na hindi kaya niyang maging receptors yan ng receptacle ng mga knowledge na galing sa sarap. Dadaan ito sa conduit ng mga mouse, ng mga agricultural technicians. Kaya yung sinasabi ni Vicky na mga maraming linkage with the DA, at ang DA after na mag-develop ito, ilalagay ito sa kanila, ang user. So, ganyan din ang mangyayari. May mga certain technologies we have to put directly sa farmer and in what way siya i-extend. Di ba, mayroong printed. Yung nga printed, nawawala, ginagawang palutan ng tinampas ang palingke. Pero itong pag-isad mo kayo, yung gagawin ang palutan ng tinapayin eh. At take note, kahit nga magtitinda ng taho, may cellphone na, di ba? Sige, meron itong ataon sa division na amin na nag-order ng taho eh. Cellphone ang ginagawa. So, paabo. So, yan ang you will note that we have to go with the modern times. Yan naman po ang sasabihin ko. Sasuggest ko lang sa sarap eh. Medyo elaborate yung ilimanais para maintindihan ng iba't ibang sektor ng society at ang masalamat.
Meron po talaga tayong oras na nakalaan sa pag-train po ng ating mga partner mga
fields sa Japan because younger people are not interested in farming. And they have so much money that they can purchase food from outside of Japan. So tayo, ganun ba ang gusto natin? The problem is we do not have enough money to purchase enough food from somewhere else. So we need to go into farming and convince young people na come and work with us. Farming is not just about getting your hands dirty. But actually, the fun part is in getting your hands dirty.
Okay, napaka-interesting ng ating open forum. Palakpakan po natin muli si Matonya Dean Abenga. Okay. So ngayon naman, gusto niyo pa ba ng prepaid card? Ha? Gusto niyo pa? Gutom na kayo. Huwag kayong magkalala kasi paglabas niyo mamaya, bibigyan kayo ng kit na may konting pagkain. Konti. Na may pagkain na mapapawi ang inyong gutom ngayon. Pero before na nilibigay yung kit, we would like to request sana na yung CS customer satisfaction feedback forms, yung half page na binigay namin sa inyo, paki-fill out po yan, and then para ma-claim yung paglabas nyo yung inyong kit na may merienda, may pagkain. Okay? Gusto niyo pa ba ng prepaid card? Okay lang sa inyo mag-stay. Limang tanong lang. Okay? Sige, tingnan natin kung sino ang magwawagi ngayon sa unang tanong. Ang unang tanong natin, what does SpeedTech stands for? Ano ang ibig sabihin ng SpeedTech? Can somebody help me identify kung sino ang naunang parang meron ako nakita dito. Mamaya na lang si Kuya, sorry ha. Pero tumaas ko ulit mamaya. Si ano muna, si from Batangas State University.
The meaning of this speed class identification technology.
Very good. Palakpakan natin. Ito ang iyong prepaid card. Ay, mali. Ano ba sinabi niya? Ulit. Sorry. O, si Kuya na. Ito na.
Our incoming student program is college. Smarter Test Identification Technology.
Smarter Test Identification Technology. Ito na, ang iyong pang-download sa Google Play Store ng SpeedTech. Okay? Ang susunod nating magwawagi ay ang makakasagot ng tanong na napakadali. Una, pangalawa tanong. Name the two major features of SpeedTech. Take na lang mag-design.
Test and disease, library and identification.
Test and disease?
Library and using as second is identification.
Okay, very good. Ito na po yan. Ngayon, 100 peso worth Globe Mobile prepaid card. Congratulations! Ito, napakadali. Unahan, ha? Okay, doon ka sa, sa libo. Para makita mo kung sino ang una magtataas ng kamay. Third question. Name at least three crops considered during the development of SpeedTech. Ayun na, yun nasa likod mo. Sorry po.
Fresh corn, banana, cucumber.
Okay, very good. Congratulations! Pakiplayin ang iyong mobile prepaid card. Ito, medyo mahirap na madali. No? Ano yun? Time na daw, 12 o'clock na. Okay, last two questions. How many PES data are currently contained? Oh, meron ng sagot. Yes, ma'am.
62.
Very good, ma'am. Magaling nyo. Magandaan nyo. 62. Congratulations, ma'am. Ito na, last question. Aha, unahan na kayo. Name at least one out of the three ways that can be done in identifying pest and disease using the mobile app.
Thank you very much for coffee, and please don't forget